Hi friends, this is Venkateswarlu. Welcome to VENHAR Reality Hyderabad. Today we are going to discuss a very hot topic, why Hyderabad is emerging as a real estate destination. Why many MNC companies, they are establishing their businesses, industries in and around the Hyderabad. What factors which are contributing towards the attraction of this establishment of their industries. Let us analyze point by point and what factors, these factors, how they are contributing and how the employment is going to generate, and this employment generation, how it is contributing towards the real estate scenario and real estate demand in and around the Hyderabad. Now, coming to the general points, this is the availability of the land in all directions in and around the Hyderabad is plenty. At even, that is, at affordable prices, one can get it in compared to other major cities in India. And abundance, second point is abundance in availability of the skilled manpower, unskilled manpower, semi-skilled manpower, which are meeting the requirement of the industries. And a large NRI base from the Telugu speaking states who are willing to invest their money in and around the Hyderabad, and cost of living in Hyderabad is reasonable and cheap in compared to many major cities in India. And the culture in Hyderabad is very cosmopolitan nature, where the foreigners from other people from other states can easily come and stay comfortably. Similarly, sixth point, the climatic conditions in and around the Hyderabad is very pleasant. No much severity in the, as far as the hot and the cold conditions. Lot of situation in Telangana state itself, even in Hyderabad, is very good. And political stability also very good. There are no much problems as per the political stability. And the rental and lease costs are very less, which are mainly attracting the companies to establish their establishments in and around the Hyderabad. Then availability of the water and electricity is good, which are main contributory factor for establishing any industries. Water and electricity is required at a reasonable cost. And the specific problems, so now we have the general points we have discussed, and the Telangana state government is taking so many proactive measures which are helping the MNC companies and attracting the other companies from the other states also to establish their establishments. The Telangana government taking industrial and business friendly initiatives, lot of initiatives being taken by the Telangana government which are of business friendly and industrial friendly, like such as TSI pass, which is time bound permissions for the businesses and industries, and the larder situation is good, and the T hubs and the training innovation cells, and the task Telangana Academy of Skill and Knowledge Centers, which are training the manpower as per the requirement of the industries, and the TSIC, that is Telangana State Innovation Center, which are being established for innovative in new technology like artificial intelligence and many latest emerging technologies, and the DRT, that is disaster responsibility team, that is disaster responsibility team, which is taking care of the any type of eventuality, sudden floods, this type of scenarios, they taking care of the and meeting the requirement of the solutions. And the same way, she teams, which is established for the women employees and for their safety. And the traffic ease measures also being taken by the government in terms of the ORR, that is already, which ORR is the outer ring road, which is established in the 158 kilometers around the Hyderabad, and tribular, that is a regional ring road, which is going to come up within 5 to 10 years in the 348 kilometers of the area. And the road widening inside the in and outskirts of the Hyderabad, and shifting of the companies from the inside the core Hyderabad beyond the outer ring roads. And the free flow of traffic is being as a target targeted by the so many measures being taken for the free flow of traffic by the government. And under SRDP program, there are so many measures have been taken which are increasing the infrastructure in the city. That is like skywalks, flyover, underpasses, underpasses such as this. Even the Musi River, which is creating lot of pollution, there have been measures being taken to reduce the pollution levels of the Musi River. And expansion of the MMTS and metro, expansion of the MMTS mostly it is further planned from the west Lingampalli, it's a plan to extend up to Shankarapalli, and in the south it is expected to extend from the Shamshabad up to Shadnagar, and the east side from the Uppal up to Ghatkesar, even from the Uppal up to Hayatnagar. And the metro train also there is expansion is planned in the phase 2. There are 3 lines planned from the Rayadurgam to Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, from other is the Nagol to LB Nagar, from other is the Miapur to Lakdika Pool via Gachiboli Mehdipatnam. And to ease the traffic, these measures are being taken and which are going to create a lot of comfort to the commuters. And Hyderabad is becoming a hub for the IT, and is going to become a hub for the pharma companies, and is going to become a hub for the biotechnology, and it is becoming a hub for the manufacturing industries. In the IT hub, there are a lot of IT companies are being established. In the mostly it is concentrated, it was concentrated in the western part of the Hyderabad. Now it is being dispersed under the grid policy, that is grid policy growth in dispersal. That means there are all around the Hyderabad there are 12 more industrial parks already established that is going to be converted into the IT hubs. And the pharma company around Hyderabad there are a lot of pharma companies are being already established. All companies going to come to the pharma city. Pharma city is being planned in southeast of Hyderabad near Mucharla. It is coming up in 19,000 acres of the land with 64,000 crores of investment, with the world's highest quality is being ensured in terms of the effluent treatment, in terms of the pollution levels bringing to the lowest levels as per the world standards. It is being planned, it is coming up, and for progress in acquiring the land in the pharma city. And the biotechnology also, Hyderabad becoming a hub in terms of even the genome, where it is established in the Shamirpet, it is providing the meeting the demand of the world's demand up to 30% in vaccination. And manufacturing hub, Hyderabad becoming a manufacturing hub also. There are the 2 manufacturing hubs. The pharma city also has given the status of the NIMS by the central government. There is a separate NIMS at Zahirabad is coming up, which is coming in 12,635 acres of the land with the employment generation of the 2.44 lakh employees is coming up. And this NIMS is going to this much employment here in the NIMS, which is going to come, and it is very going to give the demand for the employees and the real estate also. As for the now you are considered general points and the government initiative. As for the real estate is concerned, how it is Hyderabad is performed now, let us analyze it. In 2021, the average square feet rate in Mumbai is 6885 rupees per square feet. In Bangalore it was 5150, and whereas in Hyderabad 4,720 rupees per SFT. In the post corona, the Hyderabad even crossed Bangalore in office space scenario, office space segment. In residential also, the inventory levels compared to other major cities, it is very less. In the last 3 years, even the corona period also, there was a real estate, it was growth was in Hyderabad was 142%. And there is a segment which is mostly high demand is the 50 lakhs to 1 crore segment of the properties. There is a high demand. In 2019 in Hyderabad there was a 19% growth rate was there, and in 2021 it has increased to 30%. There is a huge demand for this segment, 50 lakh to 1 crore segment of the properties. In 2021 it is increased to 30%. Taking the view of the all the factors and the industries which are going to come up in the future, and many growth infrastructure development in and around the Hyderabad that is taking place is going to be realized shortly, and it may take some time, or even shortly also there are certain measures are being taken which are generating lot of employment, and thereby this lot of employment definitely going to be increase the demand for the real estate in and around the Hyderabad. So the real estate in and around the Hyderabad is going to be going to give a lot of returns in the multiplication of the investment, but only small precautions to be taken while investing in the real estate in and around the Hyderabad, like what type of zones that particular property is coming, and whether it is coming under a 111 GO, under proper documentation, under expert guidance. These are some precautions. If you take it, definitely reinvestment in the real estate in and around the Hyderabad going to give in multiple returns. Thank you. Please subscribe to my VENHAR Reality channel. Like video and share with your friends. That motivates us to do more videos which will be definitely helpful to the real estate investors. And please share your comments in the comment section. That also helps us to do better and best videos on the real estate. Thank you.